Our commentator is Chris Schenkel.
Las Vegas, Nevada, a 24-hour-a-day city whose existence evolves around a four-mile parcel of land known as the Strip. Lined with massive resort hotels and casinos, it's one of the world's foremost recreation and entertainment meccas, Las Vegas. Live! For the 20th consecutive year, ABC Sports presents the Pro Bowlers Tour. Today, it's the finals of the $135,000 Showboat Invitational, with these five bowlers vying for the $21,000 top prize. In fifth place from Gladstone, Oregon, looking for his first PBA title, Jim Winklepleck. In fourth place from Vancouver, Washington, the colorful veteran, Ernie Schlegel. In third place from Dublin, California, the winner of more money and more tournaments than any other bowler in PBA history, Earl Anthony. In second place from our Vista, California, steady Fred Conner, who is seeking his second PBA title. And the tournament leader from Spring Lake Heights, New Jersey, the bowler who has become the dominant force on the tour in recent years, Mark Roth. You're looking at a shot of the Showboat Hotel, one of the most familiar landmarks in Las Vegas, and certainly one synonymous with bowling. When the PBA Tour first came here in 1960, there were 24 lanes. That figure has since grown to 106 lanes, and today, on two of these lanes, we'll be covering the finals of the $135,000 Showboat Invitational. Good afternoon again, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Chris Schenkel, here in the entertainment capital, and as I introduced the five finalists today going for the big money, they, I guarantee you, will entertain you. It started on Monday, 384 bowlers, and now we're down to the final five. And you know, as we go coast-to-coast on the Professional Bowlers Tour, the conditions vary with not only a pair of lanes, but the entire number of lanes within a house. Our colleague, Nelson Burton Jr., we got him right down on the lanes here, and he's going to analyze the conditions here at the Showboat lanes. Bo?
Chris, this is the first time we've bowled on a full modular bowling lane. Most of the lanes that the players play on have boards that are individually nailed together. These lanes are factory processed in Florida, brought out here, and it gives the effect of one solid board. The effect that has on the bowling ball is more skid in the front end, more hook at the back end, and Chris, tremendous pin action when you have that type of roll.
Great, Bill. We look forward to your commentary today. $135,000, we indicated, is the total purse. It's broken down to $21,011, $7,500, $6,005 is Jim Winklepleck. It's an all-West Coast first game. His opponent will be Ernie Schlegel, colorful Ernie. We'll be back after this.
Where can you find someone to service all the parts of your car with the know-how and equipment to check wheels, brakes, engine, suspension, almost everything? Someone who'll give you a written estimate and fix only what you want fixed. Firestone Car Service. That's where. 24,000 Firestone Car Service bays are waiting to serve you. For this week's specials, check your newspaper.
Every professional bowler has an arsenal of his own. Special weapons for special lane conditions. Now, you can have your own arsenal in just two bowling balls from AMF. The AMF 3-Dot Classic in hard rubber for normal lane conditions. Now the AMF 3-Dot Classic in soft rubber for lanes that demand more traction. Hard rubber 3-Dot, soft rubber 3-Dot. The arsenal from AMF.
Ross Billings of Dutch Master Cigars is in charge of curing the world's most expensive to grow wrapper tobacco. Instruments in the dark curing sheds can tell him a lot. But only his master's nose can tell the moment great tobacco says it is ready to be a Dutch Master cigar.
That's beautiful.
Now you know why a Dutch Master's like our president tastes so good. There really are masters at Dutch Master's.
And so we're just about ready to have live coverage of our first match. It's a study in contrast. The non-winner, 22-year-old Jim Winklepleck, Gladstone, Oregon, going against colorful, not only in what he says and does, but what he wears, 37-year-old Ernie Schlegel with two PBA titles. Nelson Burton Jr., he'll be stroking first on this championship pair.
Contrast in style, Chris. Ernie Schlegel, the very straight ball. Jim Winklepleck, the contemporary young cranker.
Torrey is left with 245 on the left lane here at this vast bowling emporium just off the strip in Las Vegas, Nevada.
Chris, we've been here for over 20 years. The Showboat has been a tremendous host on the Pro Bowlers Tour. In fact, the first big prize money to come up on the tour came from Firestone and the Showboat. Tremendous host. Ernie has grips that he puts in his bowling ball, and apparently he didn't have the grip just in the right position, so he's fiddling around with it. Meanwhile, the pinfall you hear in the back end, Chris, is the 245 being reset. It was cycled off accidentally.
Although you were very kind to Ernie in his last appearance on the tour, as he goes for the 245. Because he won his first career title, 246 to Bo's 214.
Well, I always said he could win. I just proved it.
All right. 22 years old, Jim Winklepleck of Gladstone, Oregon, which is, as he said, near Milwaukee, Oregon, that is. And even closer is Portland, Oregon. Looking for his first win. 5'11", 185 pounds. Beautiful opening strike. That should relieve some of the tension and anxiety for this young man.
The profile of Jimmy Winklepleck, contemporary player. Now watch this backswing up in a tremendous high power position. Look at that wrist cup. Shoulders in excellent position. Deep knee bend and a tremendous wrist action and extension through the ball. That was a great shot to open the telecast.
In his career, Winklepleck has bowled in 33 tournaments and has averaged over $1,200 in earnings per event. Well, the least he can earn today is $5,000. Has a chance at 21. Going for a double. All but the 10 pin.
Chris, we spoke about the light pins and the fast pin action here at the Showboat. There's a tremendous percentage on the light hits where you can shake them up, get them off the sideboards. But the solid hits, believe it or not, often leave the solid 10, solid 8. We can see a lot of those today, the 6-pin flying around the 10.
Good earnings last year. So he has two marks now. Open with a strike, mark his play in the second frame of our very first game. And don't forget, the winner of this opening match head-to-head will meet Earl Anthony, 32, the all-time leader in number of PBA victories. And very fitting is the fact that Ernie's wearing shades. We're in the city of shades and no clocks. Well, it looked like it was coming up too high, Bo, but there's your strike.
Well, we have that straight shot of Ernie Schlegel. He has that nice, smooth, methodical swing. But watch the difference in the wrist action of Ernie as he comes through the ball. He's in the same position there as Winklepleck was, but is at the bottom of the swing. Watch how the wrist flattens out and the hand does not go around the ball. It goes through the ball. That's an excellent shot for control, but you give away a little power.
As we said, last year he won his first and then went on to win his second on the summer tour. His first appearance on our show was in 1969 when he finished fifth in the Buffalo Open. Ooh. Tough break, leaving the 6-7 on the left lane.
Ernie just does not have his rhythm. His swing is bumping out at the back, and he's pulling across the shot. The 6-7, not impossible, but very difficult.
Well, there's tremendous pressure on these five finalists.
Well, I think in any competition, Chris, when you get that much money involved, regardless of the situation, there's a lot of pressure. It's the man who can overcome that pressure that ends up the winner.
Let's see if he can convert the 6-7. Oh, yes. Thought he had a good shot at it. So did we. But it's an open frame. Ernie Schlegel in the third. 46 through the third. So it's a 14-pin lead at the moment, held by Jim Winklepleck of Oregon. He'll be shooting in the third, spare working. Leaving the 2-4-5.
Jimmy Winklepleck, a little extra power, wanted to throw it a little harder, and he has trouble with his speed control. Occasionally he'll throw it too slow and too hard. That time he was a little too much speed. As we remember last year, Chris, though, he came out firing his guns right away and shot 279 his first game.
So it's another spare. Good mark for Winklepleck. Off to the right here a part of the house where there are a total of 106 lanes, 70 in this division. Earl Anthony is warming up because he'll be meeting the winner. Then Fred Conner, and then the tournament leader, Mark Roth. Tremendous field for the finals of this tournament where the winner will earn $21,000.
Something bothering, I guess, the feel of the ball or whatever it is. You know, many times a player will have his hand perspire and he'll just want to take some time, but there's something bothering Jimmy down there at the back end.
I think it was his opponent off to the right, too, Bo.
That's right.
Ernie moved around, yes.
Went over to get some water.
A little psych job, maybe?
I don't know. Ernie's been there before, so he's bowling a young kid. He's not going to give him much room to breathe. But this Winklepleck is a tough competitor.
185-pounder. Well, back-to-back 2-4-5s. One on each lane now.
A good lesson to be noted as Jimmy shoots the spear. Notice how the players will move to the left side of the lane, throw the ball a little harder and straight to avoid the chop. There's Ernie Schlegel. He went over to get some quote in to patch up his thumb, hoping it dries very quickly.
So a lot of damage can come to the hands of Winklepleck and Marks of the Spare because they have to bowl 56 tough competitive games to get to this point. More action after this.
I needed the mileage of a Toyota Cressida, but it didn't have enough room. What I needed was the room of a Volvo, but it didn't get good enough mileage. What I needed was a citation. What I didn't need was the price. What I needed was a miracle. What I found was a Fairmont.
Ford Fairmont. It makes a world of sense.
A world of better ideas coming from Ford.
In this country, winter isn't a season. It's a warning, telling you it's time to move down from the cold, down toward a place called Millertime, and the best-tasting beer you can find.
When it's time to relax, one beer stands clear.
Miller High Life.
If you've got the time, we've got the beer. Miller Beer.
Next, the one and only Harlem Globetrotters are in Hollywood for Baskets of Fun. And from Kids Fuel, the most prestigious men's World Cup downhill on the most exciting and demanding course on the circuit, on ABC's Wide World of Sports, next.
And again today, that great variety on ABC's Wide World of Sports, indoors in Hollywood, the Harlem Globetrotters, and the world's great downhill skiers at a picture postcard village of Kids Fuel, Austria. The World Cup competition, Bo.
Chris, it'd be nice to see Franz Klammer go down that hill. Ernie Schlegel, trailing by 8, fourth frame, has not thrown a good shot in this match yet. Has to get it together. He patched up his thumb. It's split open. He put some collodion on. It should be dry by now.
After an open frame, shooting in the fourth. All but the four pin on the right lane.
That outfit must be getting his way. Ernie is just doesn't have it together. There's a ball pulled right in the nose. He's lucky he doesn't end up with a 4-6 split. As we said, the pin action is tremendous here, and bingo.
All right. Marking with a second spare of this, the very first match. This is head-to-head competition. The winner advances. We see the smile of Ernie Schlegel from Vancouver, U.S.A.
Trying a new style this year. Sam Zurich, who finished sixth, one of the three bowlers from Paramus, New Jersey, bowls in that famous bowling center out there that finished in the top six. Roth, Schlegel, and Zurich. Must be quite a league out there.
One of the cradles of bowling. Has been for years. There, Ernie Schlegel gets his second strike in five frames. And much to the delight of his wife, Catherine.
Ernie tripped the four pin off the sideboard. That's his best shot. If he can stay up high, he's got good action high. A power player like Winklepleck tries to keep the ball light, take advantage of those fast-moving pins.
This 22-year-old professional is not married. Averaged 219 this week. And for Winklepleck, Gladstone, Oregon, his second strike in five frames. There you see, visually, the score sheet.
And that's the kind of pin action we were speaking about. The light hit just blowing the five into the 4-7. You even saw the head pin come flying back across the lane, Chris. tremendous for scoring. You know, there is some pros and cons, though, that the players have about the light pins and pin action. Some of them like it, the players that carry the light hits. Some of the more precision players have some negative thoughts about it. We'll develop that a little later.
And there will be the usual Rolaids bowling tip of the week. Today, as we continue our mini-series, it will be concentrating on getting started. Another 245 for Winklepleck.
Seems to be a little bit of mystery of what's happening with the 245. All week long, the back ends of the lane are the last 20 feet finished. Today, they're not finishing. The oil may have carried down. Now watch this good swing and inside out right next to his leg and the tremendous wrist action. That's good for him.
So the young man who finished fourth here last year in the Showboat Invitational, a biggie, continues to lead by 8 pins with a spare in the 6th and back up Ernie Schlegel.
Nobody's going to outpsych Ernie. Jimmy Winklepleck took a re-rack. Ernie's going to take one, too. He's always thinking out there. Once captained his high school bowling team for 2 years, and he's in pretty good physical shape. Ernie does a lot of running to stay on top of his game. 37 years old and really reaching his peak.
A 4-pin. And in the past, with your tip this week, concentrating on getting started, he has had more trouble than anyone.
Well, Ernie is the only player I've known of, Chris, that had to be warned about not bowling fast enough. But now he's changed his style today. He's going a la Mark Roth as fast as he can.
And Mark Roth is our tournament leader waiting in the wings. First, the winner of this match will go against Earl Anthony, then Fred Conner, and then in the final match, Mark Roth.
You know, taking a lot of time on the approach, Chris, is really not conducive to good bowling. Once you get by 3 or 4 seconds, the muscles seem to tighten up, and you don't have that looseness and relaxness that you need to move those pins and be consistent.
Thanks in the 7th frame for Ernie Schlegel. So we're going to take a break, only to return to the Showboat Lanes in Las Vegas, Nevada, after this message.
I got this new little car to help me save gas. I'm counting on Quaker State to help me save the car.
Does Quaker State really help cars last?
This little car has done 104,000 miles, and I think Quaker State's had a lot to do with it.
180,000 miles between my Saab and my Fiat.
More than 100,000 miles with regular care and Quaker State all the way.
There's a very simple reason why Quaker State is America's number one selling motor oil. Quaker State helps cars last.
This winter, plan indoor home improvements around the Super 8 Value Circular from True Value Hardware Stores, where you'll find specially priced values like this Master Mechanic 5-piece screwdriver set for $298, or the Sensor Safety Light for just $348. Quick Set's attractive Tylo design entry lock set is just $7.88. The long life 3-way bulbs from GE are an energy saving value at 98 cents each. And True Test polyurethane varnish is just $3.98 a quart, only at participating True Value hardware stores and home centers.
Next, the one and only Harlem Globetrotters are in Hollywood for Baskets of Fun. And from Kitzbühel, the most prestigious men's World Cup downhill on the most exciting and demanding course on the circuit, on ABC's Wide World of Sports, next.
Yes, the one and only Globetrotters, Harlem Globetrotters in Hollywood. And Bo, the men's downhill has to be one of the most exciting events in all of competition.
Well, Chris, those players are in such tremendous physical condition, those skiers, and it's really enjoyable to watch them. Winklepleck trailing, leading by 8, 7th frame. Nobody has a double yet.
There's one half of a double for Winklepleck. That strike coming in the 7th frame. It was matched earlier by Ernie Schlegel. So now with a double here, he can increase his lead to 18.
Winklepleck's throwing the ball really well today. He's taking his time, what we call waiting for the shot. He's not rushing the line or pulling up. And when you have that, you can bowl some big games. Right now, he's in a position to open up the 18-pin lead.
Oh! Look at the shaky four.
As we said, the percentage on the light pins is in the light pocket, and his ball cuts through very sharp. We watched his head pin go to the sideboard, go right between the four and the seven, Chris, and normally it would take out the four.
And with the next ball, Winklepleck did just that. We're in our first match. So for Winklepleck, it's 134 through the seventh with a spare in the eighth. Now with the strike up and a big frame bow here in the eighth, strike working Schlegel.
Schlegel can take the lead for the first time. Trails by eight, strike working.
12, 300 games, two PBA titles. Nope. Seven wobbles, stands.
Ernie just could not get it together. That was a key shot in the match. He could have taken the lead. And he just is varying his speed, not lofting the ball consistently. He has to take your time and get your thoughts together. Catherine, who helps Ernie with a lot of his bowling, knows what the score is.
Spare in the eighth for Ernie Slater.
You know, it's interesting, Chris, that he would change his style at this point or a juncture in his career. He took so much time, as we all know, on the approach before, and now he takes some time, then he goes quickly, takes some time, and goes quickly, and it seems to be affecting his rhythm. He has nothing standardized.
Pennants of winners on the PBA Tour, the far end of the lanes. Moving to the line now, Schlegel. Oh, 2-4-5 here. Coming in the foundation frame.
Just not rolling the wrist on the ball. He's very accurate too. This is spot at the arrows, but you must roll that wrist underneath the ball to impart the lift and revolutions to make it finish. The ball just sliding by.
Quickly goes for the 2-4-5.
Seems like Ernie has awful lackadaisical attitude out there, Chris, bowling for $21,000. That's a lot of money. I think I'd be bearing down a little harder.
Well, he won't be out costumed, that's for sure, today.
Winklepleck, 11-pin lead, 9th frame, spare working.
And the 22-year-older comes through in the 9th frame. The winner will meet Earl Anthony, the lefty. There he is.
And I guarantee you the action will pick up next game. This man knows what 21,000 is all about. He'll bend his back. Winklepleck, leading by 11, can shut out Schlegel with one more strike. 10th frame.
Look how carefully he placed himself on the approach, the grip now. And to the line.
Situation becomes this. With a spare and a strike, he shuts out Schlegel with a 194. Chris, if he gets spare a 9, it opens the door for Schlegel to throw 3 strikes, and if we can have a possible tie like we did last week. Gets a break to 2-4-5, breaking down, just leaving the 5-8.
Well done. The bowl earlier, we were talking about getting started, slow play. We could tell a lot of our amateur bowlers that they should move as quickly as possible, otherwise they lose a lot of friends when they're having a friendly game, right?
I agree. Plus that 9:30 legal, I sure appreciate you bowling a little quicker. The situation for Jimmy Winklepleck is this. If he strikes, he wins. 9, Schlegel could possibly tie him. If he gets 8, Schlegel could possibly win. Definitely in the driver's seat. 1 strike to move on to the next match.
Leaving the 2, 193 for the 22-year-old Oregonian. In Bo, we started out the 20th season last week with a 2-2-2 tie in Anaheim.
The situation is this, Chris. When Martin and Dickinson tied with 222, Schlegel has that same opportunity. He needs 3 strikes to get a 193 and tie Winklepleck, initiating again another 2-frame roll-off.
And Bo, in this game, he has only 3 strikes.
He would really have to draw on everything he has. His timing is just not up to par today. It would be tremendous clutch performance if he could do it.
There's one. Only two more. Only. It is a huge, huge assignment for any professional.
This capacity crowd, Chris, can feel the pressure. There is not a sound in the building when Ernie Schlegel steps on the approach. He needs two more strikes to tie. He threw a nice, controlled, relaxed shot in the first frame. Has to do it two more times.
I went back to his lower, his earlier, slower style on that last shot. Can't blame it. What a tremendous finish to sort of a, well, dismal game. But we're getting a closer that's beautiful.
I cannot give Ernie Schlegel enough credit for putting himself together just to get those first two strikes. Here's the form and his reaction to that second strike. He needs one more to tie. Look at how he come through that ball. Those are the best shots he's thrown all game. Now he's in position to tie. Once again, look at that. He's got his fingers up. He needs one more. He needs another finger raised to go into a sudden death playoff.
Standing room only here at the Showboat Lanes, our live coverage. A 190. So, winning by three pens, Jim Winklepleck wins it 193 to 190. Now let's pause a few moments to hear these messages from some of the people who are bringing you this week's stop on the Pro Bowlers Tour.
This ABC Sports exclusive is being brought to you by Ford and your local Ford dealer who invites you to test drive the 1981 Ford cars and trucks, including Escort from Ford, the world car company. By True Value Hardware Stores. True Value, more than just a name, it's our way of doing business. And by Firestone, makers of the 721 steel-belted radio. In 78 years, Firestone has never built a tire in which they've had more confidence.
All right. We go into the second game, head-to-head live. Earl Anthony is the opponent. He'll meet the winner of the first match, Jim Winklepleck. That match will begin in just a minute.
Gee, Ollie, this windshield's so messy, I can't see. We need new wiper blades.
I know that.
Make sure your windshield wipers work when you need them. A new set of Anco wiper blades every year is a quick and inexpensive way to see your way clear.
Ollie, without new Anco wipers, we could have been hit by that piano. Oh. Piano! No! Oh! Oh!
The new Bic roller feels so smooth you don't just write, you go with the flow.
Come on, Dex, let's take a shower.
Hey, don't rush me. I'm going with the flow.
I can't write a fan letter to the Bee Gees with a pen that mushes down.
Get with it, sister. Go with the flow.
The new Bic roller lets you go with the flow and go, because our point won't turn to mush no matter how hard you push.
We've done it!
We've taught Herman to go with the flow.
The Bic roller, go with the flow.
Monday at 9, 8 Central and Mountain, the Dynasty Saga continues.
Jim Winklepleck has earned the right to go against Earl Anthony with a 193-190 win over Ernie Schlegel, who earned $5,000 in the Showboat Invitational. Now, there's a 20-year age difference, 42-year-old Earl Anthony on the right, a non-winner, the opponent, Jim Winklepleck. 32 championships for this great competitor.
And watch the speed he takes on the approach. Ideal, methodical. One, two, three, here we go.
Well, he thought he was going to get a split. Converted it. He has a 4-7. A little sigh of relief for Earl Anthony as he did a quick look at his wife, Susie, in the stands.
He said, I only missed an arrow on that one.
All right. Earl Anthony, originally from the state of Washington, now bowling out of Dublin, California. And again, it's a West Coast game, Bo. We'll continue that way till we get to the finals, and we'll get an East Coast tournament leader named Mark Roth.
All the big guns out there today.
And the first game winner, Jim Winklepleck, Gladstone, Oregon, opens with a strike.
Here's the pin action we were talking about. Watch the ball tear into the five, just go flying right into the seven, just everything going after the four also. That is a tremendous pin action we have seen so far here in this tournament. 56 games, and the light hit is definitely the one to live by.
So, the 22-year-old immediately puts the pressure on the great champion, Earl Anthony. Winklepleck with a double now, with a spare up shooting in the second on the right lane of this championship pair. Look at him. 6, 7, 8, 10. Terrible looking thing.
Well, you know what has happened, Chris. It's been about 10 or 15 minutes since Earl is throwing a ball on the left side, and the lane is hooking just a little bit more. He throws this ball really well, just not quite hard enough. He hasn't read the lane yet. He'll have to make an adjustment. That was a good shot, just too far outside on the lane.
Oh, tremendous try by Earl Anthony. For Earl, it's an open frame in the second. Earl Anthony has finished second in the Showboat Invitational three times, and look at that attempt.
Another example of the light pins, Chris. You notice how that pin just went flying right by the seven. Earl, methodical, he knows what he's doing out there. He's going to try to figure this pair out of lanes out, and he's never out of a match.
There's the Anthony style, hitting that pocket on the left side. It's a long week, 56 games, as we said, and look at the leaders. Randy Lightfoot in the first, Winklepleck and Mark Roth sort of tied it up after there. And Mark, our tournament leader, he'll bowl in the final match.
Winklepleck, a chance to extend his lead to 35 pins early in the match.
Two, four, five, seven, eight.
Here's what happened with Winklepleck. He threw the ball wide again. He had had that 2-4-5 combination three times in the earlier matches. This time he doesn't get the 7 and 8 out. He's got a tough spare.
Well done. Five relief and a spare in the third for Winklepleck. This is our second game. Third game will feature Fred Conner against the winner of Winklepleck, Anthony.
Jimmy Winklepleck loosened up after winning his first match, but he's got to watch that he doesn't get psyched out bowling the great Earl Anthony. I imagine that he used to watch Earl Anthony on television when he was in grade school. He has to keep the pressure on him. Shots like that will not keep Earl Anthony down. He has to keep his composure and bowl his game. Forget the opponent. Leaves a 2-5-7 split.
So now, each professional with an open frame here in our second match, head-to-head, live from the Showboat lanes. We're going to return to Las Vegas, Nevada, after this message.
got tough congestion. Sinex is the long-acting nasal spray that can give you a second of and 10 hours of instantly. Medicated Vicks vapors penetrate your nose with a powerful feeling of relief. And Sinex decongesting medicine shrinks swollen nasal membrane so air can flow through. You breathe free up to 10 full hours. For tough congestion, get the Sinex extra feeling of relief. A second of 10 hours of
Inside Firestone's newest 721 radial are two belts of steel cord. In each cord, 10 strands of high-strength steel. Seven strands around two, wrapped by one. 721. Because it's a metric radial, it can use more air, so you use less gas. We call it the Fuel Fighter. Designed to save you more gas than any steel-belted radial tire Firestone has ever built. Firestone's newest 721, the Fuel Fighter.
Occasionally on our live telecast, we have a time problem, so the action continued while we were away. Earl Anthony on the right lane left the 10-pin on his first ball, covered it easily with his second ball, so he is marked with a spare in the fourth frame, trailing by six. Now over on the left, the lefty.
Earl once again having a little bit of problem. He adjusted on the right-hand lane for the high split and left the 7-pin. That time he threw the ball just a little harder, and you may have heard the ball click as it went down the lane. We said these are modular lanes. They are actually sectioned together with an expansion room in there, and his ball's hit one of those expansion boards.
Nice job on the 3-5-6 for Earl Anthony, the man that loves the game of golf.
There's Earl's son, Mike, who came down to watch his daddy this week, and Mike says his bowling career is moving along pretty well, too.
All right, now Winklepleck. See if he rebounds after an open frame, 71 through the fourth, shooting in the fifth. Sure did. Jim Winklepleck, who finished fifth out of a field of 384.
Perfect shot. Watch the six drive straight into the 10, knocking them all out. Winklepleck definitely is throwing some great shots. It's just that his off shot is just getting him in trouble. Right now he leads by nine. Strike working can extend to 19 through six.
There it is. Fencing double for Winklepleck. Last week's winner came from the number five position, Steve Martin in Anaheim.
What a nice touch Winklepleck put on that shot. He threw the ball a little harder and more direct at the pocket to get the ball up there solid. He had been light when he tried to swing it and throw slow. He has got Earl in trouble.
Out of the left of center, the man looking for his second strike, shooting in the sixth frame. Leaving a six.
Earl continuing to make adjustments. High on the first shot, left the 7-pin while we were away. Now at the 6-pin. He's right around the pocket, but he just cannot nail it down. Perfect.
As we indicated earlier, finished second three times in this event, looking for his first win and marking with a spare in the sixth frame.
Go ahead, Chris.
The loser of this match will get $6,000. The winner of the Invitational will get $21,000. It'll happen right here today, live.
It's unusual that Earl Anthony would be the leading money winner here. He's never won the tournament. And I actually asked him why. He says he's just bowled poorly on this TV pair.
So there's that elusive strike. Only his second in seven frames. So it's a sudden victory type situation. Only one game head-to-head. You win, you advance, you lose, you're out. We'll be back.
Now comes Miller time. The flag is dropped, the race is a memory. And now you're coasting into the best tasting beer you can find. Miller High Life, America's quality beer since 1855.
If you've got the time,
if you've got the time,
we've got the beer.
If
you've got the time.
We call this the Cinder Block Mountain, a tough climb for any 4x4 pickup. And you know that 4x4 gas mileage is an uphill battle. But this is a 1981 Ford. It combines toughness with the best gas mileage ratings of all six-cylinder 4x4 pickups.
and it's the only American-built pickup with independent front suspension to step over bumps independently. Yes, Ford conquers the mountain with the best gas mileage, and it's built Ford Tough.
Jim Winklepleck shot in the eighth frame with a big strike. The action continued because of a lack of time while we were away, and in the seventh frame, Jim had left the 2-8, covered it easily, marking with a spare in that, and then coming back with a strike. Now, man that needs to string them together with a strike up, Earl Anthony shooting in the eighth frame. Crossing over, he'll take it. Never seen him turn around at the line so quickly, thinking, well, that's a dud.
He's a bit at a loss how to play this lane, but he gets a tremendous break as he hits high on the right side and just pushes the 4-7-8 out. Chris, he's in the match right now. He only trails by 8 pins. He can take the lead for the first time with a strike in the ninth. Double work. Seesaw match. Anthony taking advantage of that tremendous break in the eighth, capitalized in the ninth, now has the lead. Winklepleck once again, though, has a chance to recapture it in the ninth. Strike working.
All but the four.
All week long, we've seen this tremendous pin action, pretty good scoring. What has happened today is that the oil on the lanes from the players practicing has carried down to the back end. The ball will not quite finish like they wanted. And watch Winklepleck. Thinks he has a strike, and he's disappointed.
That comes right back and methodically covers the floor in the foundation frame. Marks with a spare. Very close second match. The winner to meet Fred Conner.
As our first match, this is going right to the 10th frame. Winklepleck trails by two. Would love to get the first one here in the 10th. He's made the adjustment on this left-hand lane. When the oil is carrying down the lane, you go a little straighter at the pocket with a little more speed.
All right.
Got a tremendous break on that one. He thought it was wide. Just tipped the head pin and wiped out the left side of the lane. 2, 4, 5, 7, 8, all being taken out by one single pin, the head pin.
You just joined us in our first game here in Las Vegas. Jim Winklepleck, at whom we're looking, defeated Ernie Schlegel 193-190.
Could take the lead with this shot.
I hit the 610.
The best he can do is 199 with a spare. Earl Anthony going at a 201 pace would still have to fill at least 19 in the 10th frame. Winklepleck with a tremendous power, but gave it a pull and it went across lanes.
With a lot of speed, covering the 6-10, and it's a 199 game, second game for Winklepleck.
It'll be interesting to see how Earl plays this. He has a two-pin lead, double working, so he needs to fill at least 19 here in the 10th frame to win the match. He's had some sporadic shots on this left, on this right-hand lane, some high and some light.
Leaving the 7.
Chris, if he converts and strikes, he wins by 1. If he converts and gets 9, another tie.
Another tie, and then a two-frame roll-off. Like the ninth, and there's Mark Roth, the tournament leader. Now Fred Conner, who will be up next. Mark is the tournament leader, has to wait another game. All right, he has covered the 7. Now, it's the strike that Earl Anthony wants.
Jimmy knows the score. All he can do is sit and root and hope. Earl Anthony must strike to win. If he gets 9, it's a tie. 8, it's a loser. After 56 games, it's down to one shot.
Yeah, Earl Anthony, 32 PBA titles. Gets that strike and bowls 200, winning the match by 8 men. Fred Conner is Anthony's opponent next.
There's Dan and Ellen Fields. He's editor of our local newspaper. He looks worried about his problem dandruff.
I wish he'd ask me.
Mr. Owens, what shampoo should Dan use for his problem dandruff?
Ellen,
how about Tegrin?
It works on itching and flaking.
In a national survey, 3 out of 4 dermatologists judge Tegrin's medication effective in fighting even problem dandruff.
Let's try it out.
How's Dan's problem dandruff?
Tegrin's terrific news, Mr. Owens.
Prove it to yourself. Tegrin works.
Nobody has to tell me to get on the stick. With the wide stick, I don't waste time or money. See, Speed Stick deodorant is so much wider than the other leading stick. Gives you effective protection in just a few strokes. And if you've been using an aerosol, look, you'd use up 2 3-ounce sprays and start a third before you'd use up 1 2.5-ounce Speed Stick. So get on the stick.
Makes sense.
Speed Stick deodorant. The wide stick.
By many.
I can't believe they can do it for $19.99.
Installed?
The aluminized Sears muzzler is only $19.99 installed. And read the muzzler promise.
Sears promises that the muzzler will last as long as you own your American-made car.
Or return it for refund or replacement free.
And if Sears installed it, they'll install the new one free.
Well, you can't beat that.
I think it's fantastic.
It's a great promise.
Sounds like one heck of a good deal.
The muzzler. Only $19.99 installed. Only at Sears.
We hope sincerely that you saw both matches. Our live coverage from Las Vegas. Winklepleck 193-90 over Schlegel in the first, and now, with a must strike, Earl Anthony defeats Winklepleck by a score of 200-199, and now going against hefty Fred Conner. And ABC's wide world of sports, with its infinite variety, follows this show. Harlem Globetrotters, Men's World Cup downhill skiing from Kitzbühel, Austria. All the greats are there.
Harlem Globetrotters, what a delight to the children. Fred Conner taking his practice ball. He hits 2 practice balls on each lane because he's a higher finisher in the tournament.
And the heaviest of all the 5 finalists here, 215-pounder, a licensed pilot, a hand glider.
The experience of Earl Anthony won the last match, Chris. He went harder and straighter at the pocket, and I think he'll do the same thing in this match. He's made the adjustment. He sees that the lanes may be low scoring today. He's not going to try to beat himself.
Leaving the 9 on the left lane.
The solid 9. We talked about the light pins, Chris. You carry the light shots, the off-the-wall shots, but on the really good power hits, you often lose it, such as that hit. The 5-pin just gets chopped straight off the 9.
All right, a spare for Earl Anthony, who won the previous game by a pin, 200-199. And now, your first opportunity to see Fred Conner in competition. From Mar Vista, California, 32 years old, average 218. And a former high school linebacker. Gets a break and has the strike.
Powerful Fred Conner also has a powerful game. A good, solid push away, locked elbow, hand open at the top of his swing. Look at how high his backswing is, very much like Mark Roth. Then a tremendous deep knee bend and that big extension, which gets the ball down the lane and lets it finish powerfully at the back end.
Last time on TV, 1979, the Miller High Life Classic. Lost his opening match to Ernie Schlegel. Another powerful pocket hit. And Conner comes off from the practice area to open with a double. And coming up on the Professional Bowlers Tour in its 20th year, Alameda, California next week, Grand Prairie, Texas. Then we move to Houston. Here's a man who will be there, Earl Anthony. All but the 4. More stops on the tour. Houston, Texas, we were talking about. The Bowling Proprietors Championship. The Rolaids Open in Dick Weber's St. Louis lanes.
Earl Anthony still lost on the right-hand lane. He threw a clutch strike to beat Winklepleck, but he's still fishing around for the pocket.
You know, watching Earl, though, and being in Las Vegas, he's relaxed, cool, confident, talented. Had a chance to see my pal and hear him, Willie Nelson, last night.
They say he's sensational.
Standing room only. That's what we have here at the Showboat Lanes. Willie likes bowling. upstairs. A strike in the third frame. This is our third match of the afternoon. And just recapping, Winklepleck 193 to Schlegel's 190 in the first, as you see a replay of that strike. Winklepleck losing to Anthony 200 to 199.
Fred Conner leads by 11, can extend to 21. Is bowling as well as anybody on the tour in the early going here in 1981. He's really in good shape. He got in great shape in December, and it's showing up in the first two tournaments.
All but the 10 with a double up.
Not the solid 10 that we often see. It's what we call the weak 10 or the light 10. The 6-pin does not quite get driven into the 10-pin. It lays down the channel. When the ball is hit solid in the pocket, it's approximately on the 18th board that's solid in the pocket. That ball was around the 17th board from the right-hand channel and does not get the action on the 10-pin. Cross lane, a little extra speed, and cut down the hook.
After a double spare for Conner, in the third 10-pin lead, man that won his only title in 1978 in the Waukegan Open. He had a great week. He started off the tournament in 115th place, then averaged 225 for round number two, jumping all the way to a tie for 40th, before qualifying in the number 17 position for match play finals. Then, coming in to finish second. Bowler will meet the winner of this match. His name is Mark Roth. Fred Conner going against Earl Anthony. Conner with a 10-pin lead. We'll take a break and then return.
We're away.
Every professional bowler has an arsenal of his own. Special weapons for special lane conditions. Now, you can have your own arsenal in just two bowling balls from AMF. The AMF 3 Dot Classic in hard rubber for normal lane conditions. Now the AMF 3 Dot Classic in soft rubber for lanes that demand more traction. Hard rubber 3 Dot, soft rubber 3 Dot. The arsenal from AMF.
Gee, Ollie, this windshield's so messy, I can't see. We need new wiper blades.
I know that.
Make sure your windshield wipers work when you need them. A new set of Anco wiper blades every year is a quick and inexpensive way to see your way clear.
Ollie, without new Anco wipers, we could have been hit by that piano.
Oh.
Piano? No!
Well, it all started in 1960 here at the Showboat Lanes. The 64 champion, he is now the assistant tournament director, Harry Tiger Smith. Great bowler. Now helping the other bowlers, along with tournament director Harry Golden. And now, 32-time winner, Earl Anthony. Fourth frame. Can even the match with a strike here. When it's needed, Anthony comes through. Let's go to bowl.
With me, Mark Roth. Mark, are you kind of surprised the way the lanes are playing? We expected big scores like last year, and yet the scores are relatively low. What's happening out there?
Well, it looks like the oil's carrying down a little bit, and the lanes were tighter to begin with today, and they're getting tighter as the game progresses. And I'd like to see, also say, the hostages be freed soon. I've been heard rumors, you know, this morning on the news that they might be free. I'd like to see that happen soon.
Well, I hope they get free, and good luck to you, Garth.
His second game, he defeated Jim Winklepleck by one pin, 200 to 199, to get to the semifinal match against Fred Conner. And of course, it'll be Mark Roth, from whom you just heard, that will go against the winner with a $21,000 first prize, $11,000 to the loser. Loser of this match will get $7,500. Winklepleck earned $6,000. Ernie Schlegel, in losing the first, earned $5,000. And Conner accepting the pressure and doubling, and we're back to even in our semifinal fray.
Powerful Fred Conner, just so well practiced, such good shape. You can see that arm swing coming through, waiting for the shot. He's not raising up at the line. He's staying down, staying smooth. When you bowl that way, bowl within yourself, you have to get good scores. He's all even with Earl Anthony through five.
Incidentally, last week's winner, Steve Martin, finished 42nd to earn 750. Shooting now in the frame with a three-bagger.
As the money's picked up, the action's picked up. These players really going after each other now.
And coming up here on our telecast, a mini lesson number two. Rolaid bowling tip of the week with Bo Burton. So he makes it four in a row. Earl Anthony has never won the Showboat Invitational, finishing second three times. You know, Bo, we have 70 lanes in this section of the total of 106. To give people who haven't been inside a vast establishment, it takes about 54 lanes to equal the length of a football field. So they have 106 here.
This is a big place. Earl all even through six. Four-bagger working.
Look at that. Talk about methodical. Susie. This happens.
Boy, he really put it on Fred Conner. Fred just bowled so well through six frames, is still trailing by 10 pins, has to really keep attacking that lane. He cannot let Earl to get free and ahead of him. What a difference in this match compared to the first two when the players loosen up, make the adjustment, and go for the money.
So the Brick Mason is three up. Frame now. They're beginning to answer each other. Anthony has five in a row. Conner now has four.
It's a tremendous pin action. Watch the ball barely touch this head pin. It flies to the sideboard. That pin accelerated off that ball at such a tremendous speed. That's where the scores come from. The pins today fly in such a manner and such velocity that they take each other out. Pros and cons both ways about it. Makes for exciting scoring, but sometimes a good hit is often lost. Match is even through seven.
Bowler.
Sam Zurich, Jimmy Sturt really looking good this week. Gary Dickinson was on the telecast at the Millers last week. Mike Haynes steady. Bill Coleman, former winner here. Tommy Baker always steady. Burton Lux one in. Bob Glass from Don McLaren's Midwest region right up there in 14th. Handegard and Berlin. George Pappas, the new president, made the top 24.
Earl comes up with a high hit and split the 4-6. Coming in the eighth frame.
Just a slight mistake by Earl. A little pull and a ball cuts right through the center. 4-6 split. Definitely at a very unopportune time.
All right, the open frame coming in the eighth. Now, the pin difference. Conner leading by 24. And remember, he has a five-bagger up.
Steve Tripp bowled well. Great Carmen Salvino, always steady as ever. Jim Robarge and Larry Lobb, who is bowling sensational this week. Rick Pitoni, Guppy Troop, who shoots a lot of 300s, and David Kappel, who went in to replace Kyle Shedd, who had to withdraw with a sore hand.
All right, coming right back. Strike in the foundation, ninth. Well, back up now is a man that has strung five. He's shooting in the ninth. Fred Conner, 32 years old.
Fred has bowled so well these first eight frames. He just cannot do it any better, and he's getting the results. Leads by 24. He's got five-bagger working. Ninth frame.
Last year, he earned nearly $40,000 on tour. All but the two.
would all but eliminate Earl from the championship.
He was asking for a re-rack.
Just a little time, gain some time to gain his composure. He needs to throw one really good shot here to lock up the match. Go into that final round for $21,000 against tournament leader Mark Roth.
Nine spare nine to move into the finals, Bo.
When you need nine, Chris, the best place to go is for solid in the pocket. There are no safety shots.
Six, seven, ten.
Look at how this opens the door. Fred Conner right now has given Earl Anthony an opportunity to win the match, even if he makes it, cutting right through, leaving the 6-7-10. The situation becomes this. If he makes it and gets a strike, he has 245. Earl Anthony can still tie him. Definitely a tough split. He has to go for it.
Nope. 234, a big game. Highest score of the afternoon.
The situation is this, Chris. Anthony with a strike up in the ninth needs two strikes to win. He's back in that must-strike situation. If he does not strike in this first ball, it's all over. Conner's finished with 234. If he strikes in the first ball and nine spare, we would have a tie once again. Earl taking a little extra time, making sure his feet are on the right board.
Jack Nicklaus. Bowling.
Mm-hmm. So good in, under the clutch, in the pressure. He trusted that ball wide, let the light pins and the ball roll. If he strikes here, he wins. If he gets nine spare, we have a tie once again. A must-strike situation in order to win this match on this shot.
Here it is. Two-time champion, bowler of the year, so often it's hard to count them, Earl Anthony.
Chris, considering the conditions, these two players bowled as fine a match as I've seen in my 7 years doing this telecast on television. Each player threw one ball slightly off target, but they bowled tremendous all the way through. The winner is Anthony.
Now, that's a lovely tribute, Bo. It's a 242 victory to Fred Conner's 234. The finals next.
It's really hard to believe that this colorless cream will let me gradually get rid of just as much gray as I want.
Grecian Formula 16, famous clear liquid and now new cream. It's colorless, easy to use as hair cream, no mess. Use a little every day. You're in complete control of just how much gray you slowly get rid of. Some of it, most of it, or all of it.
Now I use it just once a week or so. It's a cinch to keep it this way, looking perfectly natural.
Grecian Formula 16, famous liquid and now cream.
Respect. It's not something you're born with. It's something you earn. In the Marines, you earn respect and self-respect through tough, demanding teamwork. For over 200 years, it's been that way. That's why, though the world is full of uniforms, only one says United States Marine. Maybe you can be one of us, the few, the proud, the Marines.
ABC News brings you the inauguration of Ronald Reagan Tuesday with the innovative coverage you've come to expect.
modern-day giants, Mark Roth, Earl Anthony, practicing for that final match worth $21,000 to the winner, $11,000 to the runner-up. We hope you've enjoyed the competition thus far today. It's come right down to the last frames, and of course, Earl Anthony came through to edge out Fred Conner 242 to 234. You watch them get started here before every shot. Like everything else in life, getting started is what it really takes. And in our Rolaid's many series, our number two lesson from Bo Burton Jr. is just on that subject, getting started. So I think it'll help your game.
The Pro Bowlers Tour Tip of the Week is brought to you by Rolaid.
Before any individual can become a good bowler, he has to know where to get started. There are two basic starting positions, one with the feet and one with the ball. In order to find your proper position with your feet, turn your back to the foul line. Take four brisk steps away from the foul line, allowing a half a step for the slide. The dots are there to remind you of your proper starting position on the approach. The next ingredient in getting started is the bowling ball. Remembering to pick the ball up with your hands on the side to avoid oncoming bowling balls and possible injury. It is important to hold the bowling ball with the weight in your left hand for both comfort and balance. Then position the bowling ball on your right side for a smooth push away and a nice straight arm swing. So remember, the two key ingredients in getting started, proper position on the approach and proper position of the bowling ball in your stance.
42.
Foul! Oh, what a call! What a heartburn! How do you spell relief? Check the board, coach!
R-O-L-A-I-D-S.
Rolaid spells relief. Unbeatable relief. Relief Tums can't beat. Relief no other leading antacid can beat.
For comic relief, I put on a frown. But for acid indigestion, I spell relief. R-O-L-A-I-D-S. Unbeatable.
Rolaid spells relief. Unbeatable relief.
Now, here in Las Vegas, the bowling establishment, we have the equivalent to a Tom Watson-Jack Nicklaus match. The two greats, Mark Roth, the tournament leader, going against Earl Anthony, finishing 1-2 in the averages last year. They are something. 218-5, Roth 216-9. They've had a rivalry, though, that's just helped the sport of professional bowling.
Two best bowlers in the game, undoubtedly, for the last 10 years. Heads up for 21,000.
So Earl Anthony, opening shot, leaves the 7 pin.
Solid 7, bearing down on every ball. Contrasting style. Earl, methodical, lives within himself, nice and smooth. And then everybody knows Roth, power player.
Between them, 55 championships. 32 for Anthony, 23. For Mark Roth, who will now stroke. Living now in Spring Lake Heights, New Jersey, with his wife Jackie. 29, 185-pounder. Ranked it up. Oh, boy.
The profile of the man that can do it all, and this shot is just the epitome of what you can do. He cranks that ball up there, wrist flat, and then rolls that wrist at the bottom of the swing with an inside out and relaxed. What he did to those pins that time, unbelievable. Just ripped them apart. All even.
18 second place finishes, 18 thirds, 10 fourths, 9 fifths. Unbelievable. Oh, gets up.
Mark Roth against the very light pins just splits them apart, blows the 5 and the 7, the 6 lays in the 10, and look at that 4 pin doing a little work on the side.
All right. So Roth has doubled. Anthony is marked with a spare in the first frame, and he's shooting in the second on the right lane of this championship pair.
These two players have gone heads up many times together, and they're just about even over the years.
Didn't get the break, leaving the 8 pin.
The right-hand lane, lane 60, seems to be breaking a little more for both the right-hand player and the left-hand player. Earl Anthony is overcoming it by throwing nice slow speed and a wide hook. Mark Roth with tremendous speed and power.
All right, two spares for Anthony. Two strikes for Anthony. Mark Roth in her final game. $32,000 at stake, 21 to the winner, 11 to the runner-up.
Chris, we bowled 32 games qualifying this week, and Earl Anthony actually tied for 24th and 25th place, not even in the top 24, had to win one extra game in a roll-off, qualified 24th, and here he has come all the way up to bowl the title match.
All right, Anthony in the third frame, getting his initial strike of this game, having won his last match over Fred Conner. Now the house professional at Madison Square Garden bowling lanes, Mark Roth. And Damon Keating to the line with a three-bagger, Mark Roth.
Chris, he's the only player that sounds like that. He sounds like a herd of horses or cattle going up there. He's got very powerful legs, and that's where he drives off on that pivot step or fifth step and Mark's six-step approach and gets that tremendous power and wrist action. Leads by 21, Turkey working.
Quick to get started.
One more, Mark! Up!
And the bucket on the left lane, 2-4-5-8.
He expected that ball to finish a little more, but it stayed in that oil. As Mark said in that interview we had earlier, he knows the oil is carried down. What he meant by that is from the front part of the lane, the bowling balls themselves have brought the oil further down the lane, and the ball will not finish as well.
And so the two finest in professional bowling, Mark Roth and Earl Anthony, head-to-head for the championship. The match will continue after this.
Can you see the difference between Firestone steel-belted Tracks 12 and other all-season radials? Firestone has special traction bars for pulling power in snow, but they're hidden in the Tracks 12 tread for smooth, quiet turnpike driving. Long-lasting Tracks 12, the all-season steel-belted radial with traction you can see. Traction 12 months a year. Tracks 12, Firestone's lowest-priced steel-belted white wall radial.
When I was coaching, I was the boss. I used to feed them, dress them, get them to bed on time. Now I treat them to our favorite beer, right?
I hear from Miller.
Light's got a third less calories than the regular beer. And what else?
It's less filling, Red.
And they really like the taste. Another beer, anyone?
Yeah.
What's the magic word?
Please.
Light beer from Miller. Everything you always wanted in a beer, and less.
Earl Anthony shooting in the fifth frame. So he has strung three while we were away. He had a powerful strike in the fourth frame. So now, three in a row, he has taken the lead from Mark Roth. Mark has a spare up shooting in the fifth frame. What a match. Opened with three, Mark with a spare, and now a strike again, both.
Chris, we talk about the speed of bowling, and here's Roth's powerful ball. Watch his sharp break at the back, and none of the other players could get that today. We saw them all sliding by from that position, not Roth, that tremendous leverage he has. But we talked earlier about taking a lot of time. Here's the two finest in the game of bowling. They get up, and they get it going. They know what they want to do before they get up there. Just get their eyes set, stay loose, and put it to it.
Just like that. Double for Mark Roth in the seesaw battle. Roth now back in the lead by seven pins, and Anthony is up. Wide World coming up next here on ABC, the Harlem Globetrotters. What a joy to watch. And then the excitement of World Cup downhill skiing, the men's at Kitzbühel, Austria. Six. How did that happen, Nelson?
Sharp break by Earl Anthony. We said the right-hand lane, finishing a little more. Earl has made the adjustment. He's throwing the ball a little harder, a little more loft. Just cut through very sharply there. Three-pin going to the sideboard. Doesn't get the kick on the six. Earl with a spare heel will trail by eight.
There you see the situation in our championship match of the Showboat Invitational. Eight pins separating these two. Well, the two greatest.
With all the millions of bowlers at home and all over the world, Chris, these two players have been bowler of the year for the last 6 years, 74 through 1980.
Anthony, seventh frame, trails by eight.
Now he leaves the seven on the left lane. Nine pins separating these two 55-time winners.
Chris, we talked about the pins. The pins actually favor Roth. The power player can take more advantage of a light pin by scattering the hits. Anthony, who has the heavy rolling ball that hits on the pins, will often leave a lot of solid hits like that. So a slight advantage, Roth.
Okay, Mark Roth is back up. He has a double working. He's shooting in the seventh frame. I know it's frustrating to those of you at home when we have to continue the action because of running out of time, and that's the reason we do it. Try to recap it for you as we come back. High hit, leaving the 4-7.
Once again, the ball cutting through very sharply at the back end. Roth with a chance to extend his lead to 19 knew he was going for the throat of Anthony, so he really juiced it up, and tremendous. You can see that wrist action snap through there as the hand went all the way around the ball. Mark, not satisfied with that, leaves the 4-7, leads by 7 pins.
All right, there you see the scoreboard at this crucial match, right down to the final one. Roth with the 7-pin lead, his opponent, Earl Anthony. When Anthony shoots, he'll have a spare working in the 8th frame. Now Mark in the 8th with a spare up.
Every match we've had today has gone right to the 10th frame to be decided. This one looks no different.
Right back. Open with 3, marked with a spare, a double, a spare, and now a strike.
Some people may wonder how many revolutions Roth gets on the bowling ball. They've counted up to 15 revolutions, and that's a lot of revolutions going down a 60-foot lane. Earl Anthony, on the other hand, rolls about 10 revolutions, but he uses his power and touch more than power. Trails by 7, 8th frame.
Hit. The 10 went out, let the 4-7 stand. A man, it's his wife, Susie, Earl Anthony, who has never won the Showboat Invitational, having finished second 3 times. An anxious moment at the line, thinking it might go left-right a little bit too much.
Anthony clutched out the 2 matches he won by closing out his opponent. There's his son Mike watching. Closing out his opponent with clutch strikes in the 10th, but against Mark Roth, he better start right here in the 9th frame. Earl Anthony going at a 2:15 pace, Roth at 2:24, 9th frame.
We're in Las Vegas, live.
Anthony bowling the 5 into the 10. He had a little reaction to that, saying that I got some power too. Roth with a chance to extend his lead to 19, 9th frame.
And there's that double that Mark wanted.
Chris, and that's what we've said. That actually, the condition we have here today, Mark Roth led this tournament by over 400 pins, definitely favors his power game. He could take advantage of the light pins and sling them off the sideboard like that. That was a crucial strike, and right now he can shut out Earl Anthony with one more strike. Mark Roth going at a 2:34 pace. Anthony still has a possible 2:35. Roth taking a little extra time, asking for a rerun.
Jim Winkle. Like won the first 2 games as Earl watches very carefully. Here's a man that's sort of come out of his shell in the last few months. He expresses his emotions a little bit more than he used to. Anthony, that is. Mark. Clutch performance. 23-time winner.
And Earl just took his 4th second at the Showboat. He's the all-time leading money winner at this tournament, but he's never won the tournament. What a tremendous match they just put on. Roth still has a possible 2:54, but he's shut out Anthony. That tremendous power in keeping that ball light on the pins.
Mark Roth, winning the winner's share of $21,000 of the $135,000 Showboat Invitational. finish out to get the totals. We're going to have a commercial then to Jim McKay to return with the winner's interview.
Introducing an American car built for a changing world and designed with a commitment to quality. The beautifully new Ford Granada. Contemporary in styling, energy efficient, smaller in size.
But not at the expense of room.
With Granada's highest mileage ratings ever. And with attention to detail. The kind of detail
you can see, feel, and hear.
Now, 12% annual percentage rate financing at your participating Ford dealer.
A bright red fire truck, a blue calliope, a yellow moon, a pink balloon, a golden Dixie Jamboree. Yes, America's true colors come through on GE.
GE TV brings you America's true colors, vivid and lifelike. And with GE's special VIR2 circuit, the color is automatically adjusted.
Yes, America's true colors come through on GE. GE, we bring good things to life.
When you reach age 55, you're wanted by Kemper. Because drivers your age or older are among the safest on the road. So the cavalry wants you. Kemper offers drivers 55 and over up to a 10% discount now and guaranteed renewal at age 60 and beyond if you've been with us for the five previous years. For auto discounts and guaranteed renewal, call out the cavalry. Once you compare Kemper, you'll ride with us.
I'm Jim McKay in New York. We'll be going back to Las Vegas shortly. Right now, there are late developments in the hostage crisis. Let's go to ABC's Peter Jennings in Frankfurt, West Germany. Peter?
Jim, here in Frankfurt, where the hostages might be brought, all remains ready for their arrival. In Tehran and Algiers, day-long meetings have now ended, for the most part. And in neither of those cities, nor in Washington, is there a negative assessment. There is some caution, for there have been difficulties. The issue is money. Just how much Iran will get, how those assets will be transferred out of American banks in exchange for the hostages' freedom. Iran's chief negotiator said today, if the United States really cares, one could be optimistic about breaking the stalemate. There is an Algerian plane now ready to make that flight to freedom. For Washington's part, there is no belief that a last-minute effort to bid or kill the deal is really on. All systems are not yet go, but on the eve of the Prophet Muhammad's birthday, an aide to Iran's chief negotiator said, with the grace of God, it will happen. Now back to you, Jim, in New York.
Thank you very much, Peter. And now let's go back again to Las Vegas, to the bowling, and to Chris Schenkel.
Okay.
And in the match of the two greatest, Mark Roth, the tired Mark Roth, wins it 253 to 222 over Earl Anthony. Congratulations.
Thank you, Chris. I'd like to thank people here at Showboat for hosting the tournament again, and hope to see him next year. And bowling Earl, it's no picnic. He's always been tough, and we always have tough matches, and it just went down to the 10th frame today.
Tell us about light pins.
Well, I've been working at home on different types of pins, heavy pins, light pins, and these pins seem real light today. I carried a lot of light hits and had the good breaks today.
We have something heavy for you. President, Chairman of the Board of Showboat, great guy, Joe Kelly, with a beautiful trophy, and Joe asked me to first hand you this check for $21,000 to bring a smile.
Definitely bring a smile.
Now, Joe Kelly.
Okay, Mike. I mean, this is the second time for you to be a winner here at the Showboat. So here's this trophy, and we've had a nice time here today with you people, and I just hope that they release the hostages today, and we'll all be happy.
I agree with you, Joe. I hope to see the hostages come home, too, and I love you people here at the Showboat, and hope to see you back next year. Thank you very much.
And Joe, you've done a great job here. You're a pioneer out here, and you've done many things in life, but one of your great things is to bring the pros here. See you all later. Mark Roth is the winner. We invite you to stay tuned for ABC's Wide World of Sports, featuring the Harlem Globetrotters on Hollywood and same-day coverage of the Men's World Cup downhill from Austria.